Okay, so I'm not gonna reset it, but I start off with Lightroom for this photo. That's what I started with. This is my finished product. But let's see how we got there. I'll reset it just so we can see. Since it's already been done again, I'll just here. Oh, come on, bro. Okay, give it a minute. I have Lightroom and Photoshop open, and I need more RAM, so reset. Okay, that's the before. And that's the after. Okay, well, anyways, I already sent it to Photoshop. Edit in Photoshop. Send it over. Finished product is right here. Let's move it over. What's the finished product? That's not the finished product. Okay, so let's start. I take it back to Camera Raw. I did bring down the highlights a lot and just kind of got the tones normal. Bring down the highlights to where you can barely see them properly right here. Bring them back with Dodge and Burn. Excuse me. Come on, buddy. You can do this. Don't die. There you go. Okay, so exposure probably stays the same. Bring down the contrast a little bit, like the little matted look-ish, and I don't want it to be sharp. There's still a lot of detail here, so no worries about that. Maybe just a little bit more on the highlights. And then the shadows, bring them out. The whites, just a little bit of blacks. Bring them out a little bit too. Bring the clarity a little bit more down. Just a couple more. Dehaze. I don't need to dehaze. Vibrance is fine. This is where I do my little bit of. Curves. This is probably gonna look a little bit different from my final product unless I go back and actually just use the same one, but I kind of don't want to. Fun re-editing, even though I just edited it like yesterday. Okay. Sharpness, it's fine. Actually, you know what? Let's go here. Get that brush. Brush over. A little bit right here on the top because it's a little dark there. And then let's reset this. Reset it. Bring the exposure up a little bit. Bring the contrast up a little bit. Bring the highlights down. Shadows out. Once. Bring them up. Bring that just a little bit down. Bring up the clarity. Dehaze a little bit. Sharpness. That looks fine for now. Go back over here. Did that. Fit in view. I want this to be a little bit different. So. That like right there, go to the luminance, bring it down, bring the saturation down. Actually, no, that's good. Yeah, there you go. Oh, it's almost whited out there. There you go. Most of the purples. It's just right here, but I kind of like that. It's back to the same color. Magentas, orange, more blue. Let's go up just a little bit. Looks good. That's been messed with, but whatever. We'll add a little bit more. And you can see the ring right here, so you can change. There you go. Sorry. Alright, so let's make a copy. Come on. Copy. Okay, just mess with any little things that need to be messed with. Let's do it like this. I remember I went like this. Line it up right there. Looks fine. This was kind of like a little bit weird, but I'll do it the same way just because. Okay, so that chair's gotta go. Okay, so right there, right there, right there, right there, 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 right there, right there, right there. Okay. Let's see if it'll work just like that. I doubt it, but I can maybe work off of it. Nope. Okay. Let's go back down. So sorry. Alright, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do edit, fill, but not fill, but content aware fill. We're using the new stuff, the new goodies. So green means what you can sample from. So erase everything except that little area next to it, which is the floor. And it'll sample from just there and the floor. So just clean, clean, clean. I take that. Let's go. Okay. It's gonna make a layer over it, but it should be okay. Alright, from there you see the you see how it's gonna more or less look right here? That's okay. And actually it looks better than I did the first time, so from there. Just merge it down. I mean, you don't have to. I want to because I want to blend it in a little bit. So merge it down, and then hold on a second. Okay, so from there, we gotta blend that in, and since I merged it down, Control D, separate, then you bring out your patch tool. So I'm gonna patch this area, just a little bit, blend, nice little blends. Yeah, you see? Those lines are no longer visible. You can even just kind of... Oops. Okay. There you go. Much better. Maybe let's go back a couple. Right there? Yeah. A little random texture there. Okay, so that's done. From there, I like to start with my levels. And again, like I said, I want a little matted look, kind of slightly matted. Leave that there actually. Make the colors nicer and crisp a little bit. Let's bring this up like 3. Good, like this. From here, let's bring this up like 2. Alright, and you see now it's a little bit more matted than it was. The colors went up, like the highlights and stuff, but that's fine. Oops, I don't need that. Bring the curves, sample the area that you want. Actually, I did sample this for the black, and I liked how it looked, so. Let's go to curves again. Sample black. Okay, that's good. Actually, let's see the samples. Okay. Defeats the whole purpose of the whole little mat area, but I mean, it works. Let's go back to, how do I get rid of this? Let's get rid of this curves layer. Let's bring a new one. Oh, there you go. Jesus. Okay. Go back to this. Oh, well, you know, there you go. I like that one. Okay, so now we'll go here. And usually the highlights are like right here in this area, so there you go. There you go. I like. From there, I'll be high vibrance. I will use this later. I won't use it right now. Not really. Maybe bring down the color a little bit. Yeah, the color looks a little bit more realistic, I suppose. I didn't use any color balance. What did I flow filter? I have to use this. Okay. Oh, I kind of like that better than the one before. But no, let's keep that pink. I know it's a Fujing. Probably that one, to be honest. This one, but we'll see right now. Or maybe this is, let's look it up. Where is it? Color lookup. Kodak 5218 Kodak. That's that one, I believe. Yeah, it was that one. I'm gonna try to go to that one. Okay. From there, bring this down to like. It's a very, very small difference, but it is noticeable. Actually, let's go check and see how the other one looks on it. I think I used this one, but let's go with this one this time. A little bit different. I did remove it from her face, so. Oh. Her skin, but this is too far, so it's just this area. So, bring it to like 89 or 80%. Flow 15, and then zero hardness. And then we'll remove it from there. We're masking it, so you mask with black. I'm only removing it from her skin, not her hair, not her clothes. Sometimes I hate using the mouse for this. Feels like it gets worse and worse every time. But I do not like the tablets one bit. That's off her face. Perfect. Okay, let's keep going. To use a gradient, bring that down to. Start at 15%, and we'll go from there. You kind of want the colors to pop, so we're looking for one that makes the pink come up. We're the Tennies, and we're USAA members for life. Call USAA to start saving on insurance today. Again, I could remove the. To keep from crying. That's some good music, but not right now. Cool. Bow, 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 bow. Yeah, I like the pink, but normal overlay and then normal. Overlay. Normal. Overlay. Normal. Switch it to overlay. I'm actually gonna bring it down to like 10% though. So now the overlay is a little darker. Again, remove it from her skin. You don't have to, just preference. Same deal. 80%. mask it black. I'll probably end up ruining the whole thing. At least from her face. You see how it gets a little more yellow around her skin? That's the pink coming off. Oops, gotta exit out and flip it. Okay. Okay. There you go. Hidden. Let's look at her face. This is Emily, by the way. She's amazing. Go to like 10%, 11%. It's a close fine. Very soft brush. Just to mess it a little bit under here. Can't you see yourself on my time? And you grab from the targeted area, so kind of. There you go. She has very good skin, so not really gonna do very much to that. Sorry. Still dying, guys. 2 hours later, still dying. Sure, let's try that. Looks good. There's texture, but since I am using a 50, it's not like crazy texture. I do want to get some more lenses later, but for now I have a 35 and a 50 that I can use with this camera in particular. Do I want to really do this? I didn't do it in the other one. I cleaned the hair over here just because that was very noticeable. This one is probably somewhere. Nope. To the way that I need you, I wish I could feel your skin, and I want you from somewhere. Since there's already stuff on it, it kind of makes it a little wonky when you use this, but it works. Okay. Okay, I guess. Let's go to texture brush. mixer brush. And then let's go. Nope. Okay, that's fine. I hope this doesn't look like crap afterwards. I'm gonna have to undo it. It's noticeable. I can see it from there. Once again. Wait, maybe if I do this. Yeah, it looks like it kind of blended a little bit better. Looks cleaner as well. Little brush. There you go. Alright, better. Not too bad. I didn't do this last time for the original one that I did, but let's do a little bit of volume control here with her hair. This might kill my computer. Just FYI. Let's reconstruct this because I don't want that to be messed with. Okay, then let's move this out. Four attributes. Bring this one down a little bit. There you go. Okay. Just a little bit on that eye. Looks a little bit better in my opinion. Having looked at that before and now I feel like it's a little dark, but let's try this out and see how this works. Yeah, I'm dying, guys. Sorry. I'm not hitting that color that I want. What the fudge? There you go. Much better. Much, much better. Get those magentas a little boost as well. Hotter pink. Because hot pink is hot. What is this? The yellows. Okay. Actually, probably these are just like plus three or something. Okay. What about them purples? Oh, there's no purple. Cyans.
There in the background. Is that Jacob? Did you bokeh my child?
No, I can unbokeh. See? Bokeh, unbokeh.
I would never bokeh your child. Just so you know.
Okay, so. Let's see. What else do I need? Probably just the gradient map. Which, did I add it already? I believe I did. Yeah, I did. Let's check the levels. Just maybe I can, not levels, I'm sorry. Delete that. Let's check color lookup. Color balancing. Oh yeah, there you go. Minus three. Oh, that looks nice. Give it. That can stay at minus one. Just a tad bit pinky. And do we like? I think I might a plus one. Give it just a little bit more. Warm. So more or less, that's what it's looking like. Okay, so now I gotta dodge and burn. I do have an action, so I don't have to worry about that. Put on the main one. Frequency separation might not work. Because I unlocked it and I also have a copy already made, so we'll see. If not, I'll just remake it, it's not a big deal. Oh, it worked. Okay, so. The frequency separation I use is very cheap. Make a copy, high pass, vivid light, switch it, add blur. Well, high pass, then blur, then vivid light, and then add a mask, inverted. And then I brush it out, which is going to be pretty much the same thing for the dodge and burn. But let's go with this first. And keep it at 1500 flow, and the hardness is at that as well. Okay, normal brush, black, hides, white, shows. So, let's start brushing. Did I do something? Yeah, something's up. Hold on, let me see. Something seems off. Yeah, something's off here. It's not working. Oh, I know what it is. Jesus. Okay. Layer order is important, guys. Higher layers, visible over under layers. So if it's something that blocks, such as the original picture being on top, you gotta move it down. Now, all right, let's go back to doing this. It's white shows, so again, very cheap way to do it. There is more than one way to do this. There is a ton of ways to do it with much, much better results, but it also takes a hell of a lot more time. I personally find this works well enough for what I like, so I don't worry too much about it. You don't want to do it in the eyes, you don't want to do it in nostrils, you don't want to do it in the lips, so. And I mean, like, you can go as far as changing the difference in frequency or the opacity of the brush in certain areas if you want more in some areas and less in some. You're not supposed to do it here either, but I do. It looks fine. Just make sure you go back and clean up whatever doesn't look good with it. Which pretty much anything that's like a crease does not look good if it has it over, because it looks like a high pass filter over it. I know people do it here too. I do it sometimes. It just depends on the model and how much room I've got. Emily's wearing eyelashes. So if I didn't want to do it, that would be fine. I'll do it. I'll see how it looks, and if I don't like it, well, I'll just take it off. You can see the transparency under, so you know more or less how it is under there. You can outline, and then I feel like when you do the smaller brushes, it's too rough because you end up at 100%, it's like 14 flow, 15 flow, so it's very, very soft brush. It's a very soft brush, my bad. I forgot my English, not so good. Don't do it over clothes, don't do it over pretty much anything that's not skin. That's fine, it's just feathered in there, so it's not a big deal. Smashing pumpkins. This also helped. She has a lot of muscle, so her veins show a little bit. Doesn't look bad at all, but it does kind of smoothen them out and help hide them a bit. Don't need to, but it works out. I think that's shirt. Let's see. Yeah, that's shirt. Okay, so this is how some people's stuff looks on Instagram. Oh, all this fix on the top does not look good. I might have to cut some skin off and put it there. We'll see right now. You see it at the underneath the shadow, underneath the eyes, how it looks. It should fix once you go down. Oh yeah, I was gonna do it up to. Up to here. I don't need to do legs because they're like, there's nothing there, detail-wise. So, don't need to do that. Okay, so from here, what you do is you actually go to opacity, I bring it down to about 20 and work from there. Okay, so let's see. That's actually not bad. Let's try something else though, let's see. Still see a lot of skin detail, which is good. Let's try 15. A little bit rougher skin, but yeah, 20 is fine. Okay. Everything looks good. Perfect. Oh, that's not it. Alright. That's good. Right. Just soften stuff a little bit. This is dodge, but it's actually burn. This, for some reason, the stupid action always messes up, but. But I know already, so I just kind of do that. Okay, another easy way that I do it. I don't do what most people do, where they go crazy and brush it out. As it is, I hate the feeling of my mouth. So what I do is similar, but different. So brush to like maybe like 5. 100%. 100% on the hardness as well. You can do this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do it in one go. Depending on what it is, I recommend you could do it on two goes, like do face and then everything else. So right now I'm gonna do everything together, but I'll explain why it's better the other, like do face and then everything else, just because. I'll show right now. Okay, so now I have my brush. Anywhere that I think that there should be some burning. Around this area.
Nearest sushi restaurant.
I do add some burn to the hair.
Android Auto. Nearest Italian restaurant. In the all new, most tech savvy Subaru Forester ever.
Right here. A little bit right there. This is the dodge burn right there.
The old man was covered with tattoos and scars. He got some in prison and others in bars. The rest he got working on old junk cars.
Ooh, that's a good song too, but David Allan Coe.
They look like tombstones in our yard.
But where are we? Let's see. What's a good song? Mosquitoes.
And the neighbor said we live like
corners. Okay, so then from there, I have this right here. This right here. Right there. Okay. Pretty much anything that has some shadows, pronounced shadows, you can do this too. Actually, you know what? Let's take that out. I don't think that looks good. Okay, so right there. Oh, I do add some to this. To pronounce lines. Alright, so then, big secret right here. Little feather, and just feather it. 30 usually works okay, in my opinion. That's just me. Not great, not horrible. Now, this is what I'm talking about right here. On the face, everything feathers out really nicely. You can barely see any of the lines. But when you do body parts, sometimes you do need to feather a little bit more. But if you do it in one go, you can't, because obviously it's just one go. But it looks fine. See? Lines right here. Just a little bit of depth. I forgot I did something the last time too. So let me do that first before I do the burn, the dodge. So right here, just... And I leave that one alone. Dodge. Okay, so let's start with the hair. Do a little bit of highlights. So many lines. Catch lights up here, so let's do a little bit right there. Okay, so here is usually where I see this problem, but I'm gonna try something. So see how it looks right now. Should you do the light sides of those dark areas? Okay, this one I usually do 40 because, like I said, I have those. Like, if I do 30, you see the lines. You don't see them as much right now because I did three lines, but you see 1, 2, and 3 right there. So I do 40, kind of blends in just a little bit more, and then depending on the picture, I might switch it to overlay, and I feel like it gives a more natural highlight look, and bring it down to maybe like. Okay, so let's see. And highlights look good. The burn. It might be a little too much right here. Maybe I should erase it a little bit. Well, not erase it. That's a Dodge 40. The burn, I mean. Better. Where's the gradient? You really don't see it in the eyes. I could do something about her eyes, but her eyes are already like beautiful. So I don't have to do very much for them. Oh, I didn't even see how that looks. I blended in. You know, never mind. I don't have to do much. Alright, let's try it. We got this. Do another curves. Bring it up. How do we want her eyes to look? And let's go with the whites. Whites. Okay, there you go. Invert it. And we'll just burst them out in the eyes. It's black, so we'll do some white. Not there. So it's smaller. I just want the little rim right there. There you go. Perfect. I think it looks better than the original. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Much better. I like this one. The pink's a little overwhelming, but I do like it. Let's see if we change the color lookup to the one that we had on the next one. Where is it? Try here. And I'm not sure. So, we'll designate this. What's the difference? Oh, 83 or 95. We'll do 95. 83. What do you guys think? I want to say the 83. And I'll leave it at 83. But let me know. Let me know. As far as this is it. I mean, if I wanted to save it for the net, which I never do, I would just upload regular. But if I wanted to, I would save this as... Oh, wrong folder. Okay, so then right here, but since this is a second edit, I'll put an A next to it. PSD, save. And then save for the web. I'll save as, oh, damn it. Okay. Image size 2048. Let's see if it doesn't mess up everything. And I might have to merge it down. So I did that 2048. Everything looked good. Let's see how this looks. Okay, everything's sized up to normal. From there, I'll go file save as PNG. PNGA save. I'll do the slowest, saves the best quality. And you could tell us take high quality here because it stopped my YouTube player. It's almost done. I'll save a JPEG, a regular JPEG as well, so this looks so much better. I gotta see. Oh, again, this right here. I wanna say it's the softbox. I'm almost 90% sure it is, but I don't think it takes away from the image. I don't wanna deal with having to just add more blue here. I might not even like how it looks. I like that there's only a sliver of blue and a matching sun ray for it, so I don't know, maybe we'll see. Okay, so it's saved. I'm gonna go back to the image size. Actually, I'll go back to the brush because I'm undoing the image size. Now I'll save this file, save as, and just a regular JPEG. Like I said, I don't usually bother to do the online saving. Oh, where's the A one? I'm gonna start recording here, guys, so thank you, and maybe I can do some more later depending on the feedback I get for this. Again, I cut a lot of corners when it comes to editing by far. I mean, so many corners cut, but I still have an edit process, so let me know if you like it. Thank you, guys.